In this video, we're going to learn about how to sell final expense insurance to people who don't necessarily need them, and how I hit a record week last week.
But more about that after this intro.
Beach house vibes, maneuver the jet ski. Cause I serve a god that parted the Red Sea. Multi-million dollar commercials for Pepsi. From food stamps to more ice.
What is up, FFL crew, insurance sales gang? It's been a minute since I made a video. It's been several weeks, so I apologize. It's taken me a little bit. Oliver says hi. So last week was a record week for me in terms of sales. I know I mentioned I was going to do telesales, but I ended up kind of giving in to doing in-person sales because it's so much easier for me. I'm making $7K in a week, and I made $6,000 in one day, actually. And I kind of wanted to go over some of the lessons. For number one, it's definitely not easy. You have to put in a lot of effort. My personal goal, I've never mentioned it, is to make 100K in 90 days. And one of the reasons why we're in this dire situation, I make reasonable money with my day job, make 200K as an engineer, but we're running low on money because we're building a house, budgeted 300K for it, ended up costing 700K, so we're in a pickle needing money fast. And so that's why I'm running full speed ahead doing this. But some of the things that I learned that really helped me make that paycheck, it's definitely one of the best opportunities in terms of making money quickly. I know people have asked me questions about that in the comments. But one of the things that I guess I wanted to go over a nice lesson that I learned that I used to struggle with when dealing with people who already have money is how do you pitch people, you know, if you're doing final expense. And because most people who buy final expense are purchasing it because they don't have much money in their savings, right? They want to take care of the funeral costs so that their loved ones don't have to deal with that. So when you're dealing with somebody who has, you know, $500,000 in their savings account, how do you pitch that? And one way to do this is, you know, you tee them up, you kind of laud them for being responsible, and then you kind of shift it into other people who have been responsible will still purchase this policy because they want to strengthen their position. And so it would go something like this. You know, when you tee them up, you'd be like, you know, I sit with a lot of families. It's really cool to see somebody who's been responsible and who's been really thoughtful about their finances. And in doing that, they have a lot of savings, and those people don't really need a final expense, you know, burial program like this out of necessity, but they do it because they want to strengthen their position. And so, and then you talk about what the concept of strengthening the position is, and you say, you know, most clients that I sit with who are strengthening the position basically want to leverage the legacy. They want to use a small sum of money that they're paying into the account, and they want to leverage it into a larger tax-free check that they can give their loved ones, and so that their loved ones don't have to mess with the burden of the final expenses. They want to do this because they've been making good decisions all their life financially, and they want to continue making good decisions. And so the way to get them to purchase, again, is to kind of, you know, commend them on their financial responsibility and, you know, how they've made good decisions all their life, and that although they don't need this, this is something that's still beneficial, as it allows them to leverage their money, it allows them to strengthen their position, and you kind of approach it from that way. And that's how I've been able to sell people who are in a good position financially, but this could still benefit them by buying something like this. I would say like 10% of the families I sit with are kind of like that. Most people actually really need it. Some people don't need it as much, but it would still benefit them because it allows them to strengthen where they're at. And so that really helped me. You guys can use that and when you're selling final expenses. As always, guys, if you have any questions, let me know. Like, subscribe, ask your questions in the comments, and I'll try to get back to them. And I appreciate you guys for watching.
Don't forget to like and subscribe.
I'll talk to you guys later.
Bye.
Bye. In this video, Sightseye is going to tell you all about how the yogurt tastes. But more about that after this intro.
I don't gotta talk, the Lord defends me. I watched them all fall for going against me. Cause me and all